Hello and welcome, my dear friends. Today we are going to talk about an important dimension of our DAF, that is job experience. Many of you may have some job experience in the past, and some of you may be working in an organization, maybe in some private organization or in some government organization. So the panelists who will be asking questions, they'll be much more interested in knowing the kind of job that you are doing in an organization or the job that you have already done in the past. Most of the questions will be revolving around your job experience, and they will expect that you'll be able to answer them. By answering those questions, you'll be giving them a sort of impression and a statement that, look, I am a serious kind of a person. I do the things which have been entrusted to me. Because whenever you are working in an organization, various factors will definitely be involved over there, which they will like to know about. Number one is the responsibility. Because if you are given a task of a civil servant, then of course you'll be given a lot of responsibilities. Now, if you are working in an organization, if you are working in an organization with a lot of responsibility, and you are performing your tasks responsibly, that means you are that kind of a person who can be trusted, who can be given this important responsibility after becoming a civil servant. So this is the first thing they will try to judge. Second thing would be that whether you have got that accountability factor put in place if you are working in an organization. By giving you some questions, they'll be trying to understand that whether you have got this element of accountability when you perform any particular task. So the accountability, responsibility, and various dimensions of leadership, various dimensions of the qualities of a civil servant or a subordinate, all these things they will try to judge. And that is why I believe that if you have this job experience component in your DAF, you should focus especially on this particular aspect. How you should do? Let me tell you. Number one is that you have to know your job better. First thing is that duty list that you have, the tasks that you normally perform in your office, everything should be very, very clear to you. There should not be any confusion in your mind regarding the tasks that you have been assigned, your duty list. Say, for example, in your duty list, there are 10 aspects given. You are going to do duty number 1, duty number 2, 3, 4, that way. Each and every aspect has to be very, very clear to you, because at times they'll ask you that, tell us something about your duty list, what you do in your office, in your post. So you have to give them clearly. You should not be trying to look for the words at the time of mentioning or describing your duty list. It should be very clear to you, sir, I do this, number 1, number 2, number 3. In an orderly fashion, you have to explain to them your duty list. And the moment you tell them your duty list, they'll be asking questions about your tasks. There also, you should be very, very confident, because if you have knowledge, if you are doing a particular task regularly, then of course you'll be able to answer them properly. Another aspect is that your organization. Not only your duty list, but your organization is also equally important. So you have to know each and everything about your organization. If it is a private organization, then regarding, say, for example, what do you understand by the word private in a private organization? If you're working in a public limited company, then what is the meaning of public? What is the meaning of public limited? Why this particular word limited is there? If you are working in a government organization, at times they will ask that, what do you understand by the government organization? What is government? All these things have been asked in civil services in different interviews. So you should be ready with all these questions and answers. And that's why in my first video I told you that collect as many questions as possible. And if you have job experience, then collect these questions discussing with your superiors, your seniors, your colleagues, all these things. And another aspect which most of the students do not normally pay attention to, that is your pay scale or grade pay or salary. Many a times they ask you that, what is your pay scale in the present organization? The moment you tell them your pay scale, then they'll ask that, what kind of pay scale you'll have in your civil service? What will be your grade pay in civil service? How much salary you are going to get in civil service? Now, if you do not know, if you say that, well, sir, I do not know, I have got no idea, then that will give them a very, very bad impression. Because in today's world, say for example, you are going to a private organization for an interview. So when you go out there for an interview, you need to know that what kind of salary they are going to offer. You cannot or you should not go to a private organization for an interview without knowing the salary or pay package. I hope you have understood. That's why when you go out there for civil service interview, always keep in mind your present pay scale, your grade pay, your salaries, you know, what is basic pay, what is DNS allowance, what is CT compensatory allowance, all those allowances and all, what's the difference between allowance and your salary, why it is called allowance, all these things should be very, very clear to your mind. And the civil service, I mean, why you want to come to civil service? Is it for the pay scale or salary? So they will ask you that what kind of salary you are going to get out here in civil service. If you know, then of course they'll get a very good impression that this person knows exactly. Why I'm asking you to know all these things? The reason is that many a times a question is asked that why do you want to become a civil servant? Now, we all know that we in civil service, we have a bigger platform to perform our duties. You know, we have got diversity of work or job. You know, a lot of prestige, power, aura, all these things are associated with civil service. We all know that. But, you know, in today's world, it should not only and only be because of this civil service or social service or the service for the mankind. Of course, it is important and we are all here for this purpose. But at the same time, you should be realistic in your answer. So when you tell them that, look, civil service will provide me a bigger platform to perform my duties, there's a more challenges involved, you know, diversity of tasks is there. But at the same time, if you tell them that this civil service provides me a good opportunity to prosper in my career, I'm also interested in developing myself in this civil service because this civil service provides me that kind of opportunity. So if they ask you how, then you will be able to tell them that, look, I have been getting a pay package of this much in the present organization, and in civil service I'll be getting this, and in civil service I'll get this kind of an allowances, and I'll be getting these privileges, all these things, quite natural. We are all human beings and we need a good salary. So in a single sentence you can say that civil service will give me a platform to provide good social services, and then at the same time the civil service will provide me a decent lifestyle. And by combining these two you can make your answer. So my suggestion is that whenever you have a job experience, you know your job better and collect questions involving your duty lists and your job, your organization, and in civil service. Another aspect is that they will ask a question that do you think that present job is going to help you, the experience that you'll get in present job is going to help you in civil service. There also you'll be able to frame your answers better if you know your job better. So that's why you have to have a complete knowledge about your job experience, some knowledge about your superior as well, your immediate boss, because a question has been asked in civil service once that tell me some of the qualities of your boss and tell me some of the things which you do not like in your boss. So when these kind of questions are asked, then of course you have to be a little bit diplomatic. You cannot simply say these are the points which I do not like in my boss. You have to frame your answer in such a fashion so that you can give them a positive impression. They should know that you are a person with positive mindset, and never ever show any kind of an impression to them regarding your present job which is negative. Do not show any negative attitude towards your present job, the job where you are already, the organization where you are already working, the job which you are already doing. Always tell them that I am happy with my present job, I am positive with my present job, I love my organization, I love my job, but still I want to go for civil service because this civil service provides me a better opportunity. So there is no harm in selecting civil service as compared to your present job, because we all are career oriented. Your answer should look realistic, and that is the most important aspect. That under any circumstances, they might ask you some questions where you will be forced to tell them something negative about your present job or your present organization. But do not get trapped. Never tell them anything negative about your present job or your present organization. That's all for today. See you again. And in our next class, we'll have this academics. We'll cover academics. Thank you.